So welcome all. Today we are going to see something about distributed file system. Till now we have seen something about file system, right? In this distributed course we now know that we have different servers. They are operating jointly and for other users it seems like they are interacting to one single system, right? So now we are trying to discuss about files, how these files are actually handled, how load balancing can be done for the files, and how other kind of issues are handled in a distributed environment, right? So now, till now, as we have seen, file system is there, which will be talking about some things related to how it is stored, how it is operated, organized, shared, and as well as protected. Those are all the things we have discussed in the last video. Now we are trying to discuss about file system in distributed environment. Okay, so basically we have to understand that in normal file system, which is not distributed, there was a very I should not say simple, but still simpler than this distributed environment, where you just for naming you have a directory system, and then whatever the files are there, you have access control list, you will manage those things, and whenever accessed you can keep access related information, and in that way you can protect, keep it secure, and those all the things can be done. But in distributed environment, since all the files are not on just one server, okay, so it can be distributed among the servers. Now there can be certain clients which are outside the this distributed environment, somewhere else they are calling, they are requesting for the resource, or sometimes some of the servers within the cluster, within your list of servers, some of the servers, as some of the files are on server 1, server 2 and server 3, server 4. So one of the servers, server 4, is trying to access the files which are stored on server 2. So such kind of scenarios can also be there. So now here in this distributed environment, we will have to maintain those all the things that we wanted to in a distributed environment, like transparency, scalability, performance, concurrency, fault tolerance, and other kind of issues, right? So let me start with requirements. That yes, the first thing is transparency, right? So the file service is usually the most heavily loaded service in the any local network, right? And also we need to access the files, and it should be fast enough to retrieve and share, right? So this thing, particularly this file service, should be transparent at many things, right? Suppose we are talking about access transparency. What does it mean? In case of this files, we can understand this access transparency as suppose some client programs, they are trying to access the files, so they should not, they should be unaware, okay? They should be unaware of the distribution of files, how the files are distributed. Some of the files are on server 1, some of the files are on server 2. So they should not be aware of how the files are distributed, okay? Whether they are accessing the files on the server, same server on which they are, or they are accessing the file from a remote server, okay? Location transparency. Here you have to understand that the client program should use uniform file name space. So So whatever name it is having, so the same kind of namespace it will use for the files which are stored on the same server and the files which are stored on a different server, remote server. Okay. Mobility transparency says that see the client programs are there which will try to access the files, you know? There are administrators who will manage the files. Sometimes what can happen, the files can be moved from one server to another. Okay, but since you know that the namespace is same, so even then if the file has been moved from one server to another, in that case also the client should be unaware. Client should not have to change anything in the file access path. Okay, so it is mobility transparency. Performance transparency means the client should continue to perform satisfactorily even when the load is high, you know? So whenever you have more load, in this situation the server should have a proper way of load balancing. So what can this server do? It will keep the copy on a different place and then start this service from the different places to serve. In that case, load will be. Another thing is scaling. Scaling transparency means suppose the service can be extended, right? So whenever new requirements comes or you want to grow the network size, then you can definitely grow the network size and load can be increased as and when you want, you know? And for scaling here in our system, what we have seen till now, that scaling is a major component of our distributed system, where just by adding a simple computer or whatever the resource, one server, you can add extended computational power to your distributed system. Okay. Now, apart from transparency, there can be several other requirements related to this particular distributed file system, where we will try to have concurrent file updates, because we understand that there is replication. Okay, multiple copies are there which are kept, and we want to update those files, right? Apart from that, even if we have the same file which can be updated concurrently, means multiple clients are accessing this file and they may try to update this file, so we should have a proper mechanism to allow the access of this file and update this file so that it remains consistent before and after the update, you know? The other thing is file replication. Definitely whenever files are on this distributed environment, the replications have to be kept. This replication will enhance the scalability of the service, and it also enhances the fault tolerance by enabling clients to locate another server that holds a copy of the file when one of the server has failed. Heterogeneity means the hardware or operating systems can be different, but still we will have to manage how the files can be stored and done. For this, you understand there should be a middleware kind of software which will help you in doing this thing in a distributed environment. Fault tolerance is the same thing, that in a distributed system, some of the servers may fail, and when a server fails, there should be a proper mechanism to handle such kind of event where a server fails. If the server fails, then if we have replications, then we can use those replica and give the access to the clients, and this can be done. And whenever this server starts, whatever the state was there, as we have seen, in transactions, whatever the state was there, we will have to maintain that state and recover all the objects. Okay, consistency is another requirement where we understand that whenever update is being done, and since it is a distributed environment, the updates are coming for the resources. These resources have their own replica, and also they can be being accessed by different concurrent clients. In that case, we should have a proper mechanism for maintaining the consistency before and after the update, right? Security efficiency, which means, and so all the files are there. Earlier we had access control mechanism, so here also we should have an access control mechanism for the files being accessed. Now it is a different distributed environment, so same access control mechanism which was working earlier may not work here, so there should be a proper access control mechanism for this particular distributed environment. Efficiency means just we have to understand that file service is there, it should offer facilities that are of at least the same power and generality as those found in the conventional file system, right? So these are certain requirements here. So now we are going towards some more detail of distributed file system. One thing that we have to understand that how this file service is implemented in this distributed environment, right? So keeping all these things in mind, that these are the particular things in which are essential in distributed environment. So some of the examples we can think about distributed file system. One is Sun Network Sun's network file system. It is Sun Microsystems network file system. So basically their idea was that all the servers, all the computers will have their own client program, server program, and also they will keep some files. So they will have all these kind of things, right? And there will be a client server architecture, and they will try to access this information from one another. Here another thing was Andrew file system, AFS, which will try to minimize the client server kind of communication. However, there definitely will be certain servers, but still they will try to minimize the client server this thing. They will copy the files being accessed and keep in cache, and then it will allow access. Okay, so let us see the basic architecture, file service architecture in distributed environment. What it is saying is, in your computer, in your server, suppose what are the server components? You should have a directory service, you will have a flat file service. Okay, these are the modules necessary in this distributed environment. So we will see each of them. One of them will be client module. So one you have client module, directory service, and flat file service. Flat file services are those which will directly interact with the file. They will store the file. Another thing is application program, using which you will which will initiate the client module, and then they can access the files using these components. So starting from file service, what happens here in file service? Basically, flat file service, it is concerned with implementing operations on the content of the files. So whenever there is a file, you will have a unique file identifier. Okay, let me write it as UFIDs. These are unique file identifiers. Okay, so this is this was also there in your flat file, other earlier systems, but still let me talk about this distributed environment where you are having this UFID. So whenever you will have a file, you will have a concerned UFID. Okay, So using this UFID, you will interact with the system and access the files. So this flat file service is aware of UFIDs. Now I say what are UFIDs? So it can be a long sequence of bits, 1 0 1 0 1 1 1, whatever, but it should be unique, right? Unique for each file. Now in a distributed environment, you understand there are different servers. Now they all may be creating, they all may be having files. They all may be having flat file service component, which will store the file and assign a unique file identifier. So for this thing, what we do actually, we try to combine the IP of the server along with this some other timestamp, current timestamp at which it was created, and those are all the things to make it unique. So in this way, it is a unique identifier in a distributed environment, no issues. So whenever a request comes, so what happens? A flat file service component, this receives a request. So it creates a file and generates a new unique UFID for it, and return the UFID to the initiator who has requested. You know? Now the next thing is directory service. Now you have already seen directory service in normal file system, which is just for naming conventions, right? So it will convert your, I should say, it will map between your names to UFIDs, hai na? So this is something what the directory service does. It will map your names to UFIDs. So whenever you will try to access certain file with name, directory service will convert it to UFID, and then flat file service will allow you to access the files from using UFIDs. That is the only thing. Now what can be a client module? You can understand every client computer will have this module, which will have the operations for accessing the files, whatever we want to do with the files, either accessing, manipulation, or deleting, creating, and whatever. So those all operations are integrated in this client module. So using this client module, these application programs can access the files. Okay. Now these application programs can access the client module using certain functions. They will call some certain functions, you know. So what can be these functions, these operations, I should say? Suppose these are certain operations, right? What can these operations be? Something like read, write, create, delete, get attribute, set attribute, these kind of things. Okay, so if you want to read, you will just give certain things, field I and n. It is saying that if the I is within the range of the valid range of the file, it will allow read the n bits, n items from the file, whether it can be bytes also, starting at the item I, and return it to in data. Okay. Similarly, it will write operation, it will create, and this UFID is returned, and delete operation, it will remove, get attributes, you will give this file ID and you will get the attributes. Set attribute is there, you can change the attribute values. So for more detail, definitely you can see this book. where you can find out these things. And now there are certain directory service interface operations where it is lookup, add new, unname and get names. Okay, so lookup will locate the text names in the directory and return the UFID. Add names will do something. If the name is not in the directory, it will add name and file to the directory and update the file's attribute record. If the name already exists in the directory, it will throw an exception. Now unname will, what will do if the name exists? It will remove the entry, and if the name does not exist, it will throw the exception. Get name means return all the text items in the directory that matches the regular expression with the given pattern. These are the kind of things that it will do. The other important thing here you have to understand is about access control. That in flat file, sorry, the earlier system, in Unix system, what you have seen about the access control, it will manage a access control list, and whenever a request comes, it checks whether it is trying to read or write, whether the read or write permission is for this particular user, it is the user is authorized for read, write, execute or not, and accordingly the permission is granted. What this happened in that particular Unix file system, normal file system, it was not distributed. But now it is distributed. What happens in distributed case? This access write checks have to be performed at the server every time. Every time means earlier what happened? Once the user has been authorized, then okay, it is authorized. But now the server is here, user is here, and it is trying to access every time. So it has this access information has to come through a particular network, right? So whenever this communication is going through network, so for each access you will have to authorize. So here what happens in this distributed environment, this access check is made whenever a file name is converted to UFID. And what happens? The results are encoded in the form of a packet, which is returned to the client for submission when the subsequent requests are to be made. So whenever this client will submit the request, it will keep this particular packet and then send the request. So a user identity is submitted with every client request, and the access checks are performed by the server for every file operation. So this was something about access control. You already have seen directory service operations. The other thing can be, one thing that you should understand is hierarchic file system. You understand that with the here in file names as they are, since it is directory, so inside one directory you have another directory may have certain files. So this naming ways will allow you to have hierarchic file system, right? For this add name, unname, these kind of things will help you. So these are certain things about your architecture of this particular distributed file system. Now one thing that we have to understand, certain examples, right? It was NFS and AFS. Let me tell you that there are other file systems as well, but here we are just going through two of them, as it is in book also. And certain other file systems are also possible if time permits. You can go through and you will see different new approaches are there, where you will see apart from this AFS or NFS, if you get some chance to see GFS, Google File System also, how it does. But more or like every of them must have these few things, like there will be directory service, there will be client service, flat file service, kind of these things will be there which will try to manage, you know. So let us see this NFS architecture, where what happens, every system will have certain client module and server module. So what happens, there will be a virtual file system. This is the normal file system, other file system there, let it be. Now it will have a NFS client, and also this Unix file system, which is actually the flat file system, flat file service related to the files. There will be other where you have other system also, the same thing you will have the on the other servers as well. So there you also have virtual file system, Unix file system means the same thing, it is I should say flat file service taking working with this files and the server. So in the same system also you may have client module, a server module, flat file service. These all will together will seem as a virtual file system which will keep working. So this in this way this client will make certain request to the NFS server using certain NFS protocol, and accordingly this virtual file system will help you in accessing the file, and it will be, the permission will be granted and the file can be accessed. This is the way what happens in NFS, right? Here after that you can see in AFS how it happens actually. Now you have this system where workstation, different workstations are there and dedicated servers are there. So, and dedicated servers, you will have certain files and very good, nicely kept files, and connected with these workstations. Whenever these workstations need these files, they will try to access. Whenever they try to access, these files will be transferred from them, and here on the workstation, you will have the copy in a cache. So you will have a copy of that file, and here you can access. So in this way, these two different systems are working. The other thing can be other different implementations may be there. Now, one thing that we have to understand is, in AFS, as we have seen, cache memory will be there, file has to be kept here. So we have to also understand that cache will need some consistency, you know. Whenever data has been kept there, you will have to manage for its consistency, whether you have kept the file here and in between the file at the main server has been updated. So these kind of things has to be kept in mind. So other things may be related that in NFS and AFS also certain improvements are being done, no issues. For now, what we have to understand in this DFS is that main thing is there will be a client module, directory service, as well as flat file service, you know? And this will help you in maintaining all the requirements of distributed environment, whether it be the transparency, whether it be the consistency, whether it be concurrent access, fault tolerance, load balancing, security, and these kind of things. So all these things have to be taken care of here. Thank you.